Take a look at this web page. It's a web page that's showing things that, well, maybe they look familiar to you. These are the PI ProcessBook displays that we ship with our demo system, pidemo.piw. If you notice, though, these ProcessBook displays, these PDI files, are now within a web page. So how did we do this? Well, this is with a package called PI ActiveView. ActiveView takes those displays, the PDI files, and saves those PDI, or excuse me, allows those PDI files to be displayed within any ActiveX control container. And Internet Explorer is an ActiveX control container. So what we're looking at here is the actual PDI files. Now, the reason we find this so useful is because there are some customers who have ProcessBook displays that they're so valuable in what they do. Like, for example, the Visual Basic scripting that you can see that's going on right here. There's some scripting going on in VBA behind the scenes. Yeah, that can ends up being so valuable that even though customers would like to put this information on the web, they don't want to give up that scripting capability or things like the navigating with buttons that people have gotten accustomed to. And of course, some customers have hundreds and hundreds of PI ProcessBook displays that they simply want to put on the web. They don't want to go about having to convert them all into the SVG and use them with the PI graphic web part. So that's where PI ActiveView comes in. With ActiveView, you can host these PDI files on a web page. What you're hosting is the actual PDI files, the display documents. Now, all the scripting, as I said, or the vast majority of the scripting inside ProcessBook will continue to work. The things that won't work are those things that make reference to the larger objects in ProcessBook, like the workbook objects. Those are things that will not be available through scripting. In addition, there's some specialized types of displays like PI BatchView and PI SQC, the Statistical Quality Control add-in, and those work within ActiveView. So customers who are used to using those displays tend to use ActiveView if they need to look at this on a web page. Now, a couple of things about this design you should know about. First of all, within ActiveView, you are going to have to maintain a direct connection to the PI server through port 5450. That's a lot of detail that we usually don't get into in this class, in a client class, but our system managers are well aware that the rich clients like PI ProcessBook and PI DataLink, they typically rely on port 5450 to make their connection to the PI server. Well, since ActiveView is essentially a rich client, that port is going to be required to be open. And that is one thing that basically makes most people choose to use ActiveView only within an intranet, not an internet application that would go all the way outside your internal network. And to explain this further, let's take a look at this animation here. With the PI ActiveView connection, essentially what you're going to have is a web server that hosts a page called mypage.htm. That's a strict web page. Okay. When the client hits that web page, embedded on that web page is going to be a display, a PDI file from PI ProcessBook. Now, when we host that within this local client right here, that initiates or launches an ActiveX control that initiates all the typical functionality in PI ProcessBook. So PI ProcessBook initiates an SDK, that's a software development kit, an SDK-based connection to the PI server via port this TCPIP listening port 5450. Now, I'm guessing some of you looking at this slide say, hey, hold on a second. What's this PDI stuff? I've got PIW files. Are you telling me that I have to redo all my PIW files or somehow export them, et cetera, et cetera? We've got an answer to that, a very good solution to that. This was exported automatically. I just did it a few minutes ago. I use a file that we ship with ActiveView. It is called the export.pdi. You simply load the name of a file and the destination, the path for that destination. And what it will do is generate all the required HTML code for hosting those displays on a page that looks like this. So, yeah, it'll create a page that looks like this. Now, you know, if you're a web designer and you look at this and say, hey, what's with the huge left margin? I wouldn't do it like that. no problem. If you want to do this on your own, just take this as kind of a step to generate the PDI files and give you some sample code that you can use in your own HTML files. So you're certainly not stuck with what we export. But if all you want is a quick and dirty way of getting this out onto the web, that export is very robust. Basically what it's doing is it's running a Visual Basic script that opens the PIW files, saves them as PDI files, and then generates the HTML code that will host these inside ActiveView. And that's what we're looking at right here. Okay, well, if you trust me, then you can just stop the video right now. But hey, why believe me? Let me just demonstrate it. I hate when people say, yeah, I just did this and I'm not going to show you how it worked. Yeah, so why don't I delete what I had just created and let's generate it over again, just so you can see how it works. So here's my file, pydemo.piw. It doesn't have to be open, or it could be open if you wanted to. You'll find this export.pdi in this path that you see right here. I'll just go ahead and open it up. It's normally under program files, PyPC, ACView, WebDev, and there's the file, export.pdi. You're being prompted for what PIW file you want, and you'll just have to go out and browse to that. That's going to be PyPC under ProcBook, and it's under the English version, PyDemo. Yeah, there we go. So it's found that file, and now I need to specify my output. I think my output I'll just copy and paste from here. And so what's happening now is it's launched that script and it's exporting these files. Now that, I'll just point out something. A couple of these displays, when they open up, they launch VB scripts. So that's what you're seeing here. These are not errors. These are just the normal behavior of these displays when they open. There we go. And now the export is complete. So not only is it robust, it's pretty fast. So now that I've done this, hey, there it is. That's the thing I just deleted. Double click on this. I'm doing this locally, so I have to allow this to run locally. And there we go. So now what we're seeing here is these displays that we've just exported showing up inside these this PDI files hosted by ActiveView. And things like, there are certain restrictions, certain types of buttons that are not referencing other displays that are within the same path. Those will break. But generally, if you've got everything using relative referencing, you should have no problem with your buttons. Oh, and of course, any buttons that link to, for example, a separate PIW file, like let's say if this button had linked to a PIW file, that simply will not work. This will not launch a PIW file from within here. And I didn't mention it, but of course the big finish to all this would be to take what we just generated and send this over to a web server, post this on a web server, and then give it to your users.